was the summer of 1942. I was 8 years old. I lived in the harbor town of Novorossiysk, Russia, with my parents and baby brother Eddie. I was outside playing with my friends when I saw the Germans coming, hundreds of them. They broke down our front door and took my father outside and accused him of being Jewish.
My father, he took his pants off. And they seen that he's not circumcised, so that's how he proved he was not Jewish. So they took him for free work.
The soldiers told us to only take a few things. My mother gathered some clothes and her favorite tea kettle. We were taken to a train station where hundreds of prisoners were placed into cattle cars and shipped off to different forced labor camps.
We were taken by wagons, by ship, by train, in cattle cars with all the cattle in there sandwiched in.
I was separated from my parents and left to fend for myself.
On the train station, Mama says, I'm gonna take Babushka and Edik to the train. And you stay here with the bags. Then I'll pick you up. Well, she went, and the train took off.
After a few hours of being alone at the train station, I could hear the trucks coming, only this time, the trucks were full of Jewish people.
When we went there were Russian Jews. We spoke the same language. So we were there, and your mother's friend, Angela, and I, we were in the same camp.
My new friend Ella Bernstein and I were on our way to the Auschwitz extermination camp.
And she says, honey, Dietka, don't cry. I'll take care of you. You stay with me. So I stayed with her.
Inside Auschwitz was truly hell on earth. The smell of burning flesh, people starving to death in front of my eyes. I noticed everyone had numbers tattooed on their arms. 3 or 4 weeks had gone by. Women and children in our barracks were starting to die from starvation.
We called Ella Bernstein, come on in our office. She used to go. He you know, screwed her and gave her food, you know, for me.
They told us to go into this shower area. We were completely undressed, naked. The men were undressed. They were putting the men in one corner and the women in another corner. We were all naked. And then they told us to go into the shower, and we thought, that's it.
We go have a shower. When they come out of the shower, they spray the white powder all over you. Clean it up, so no bugs, no nothing.
By now, my parents had almost given up on ever finding me. My father's only hope was to volunteer himself to the Germans to work at Auschwitz. He knew this was a for sure death sentence, but he went anyway, in hopes of finding me.
Made him take out all the gold teeth from the Jews. They had all gold teeth.
By now the Germans had gassed and burned all the remaining women and children. They told us we had to take a disinfecting shower. They took Ella Bernstein, and I found myself alone in the barracks.
I got hold of her dress, and I'm following her. The soldier took his foot and hit me, so I fell down.
So Jewish people coming in, they promised to take them to Israel, strip, keep walking, and fire it out machine gun, kill them, at least over 1 million Jews from Kiev.
Ella had warned me going outside was dangerous, but I was desperate and afraid.
Soldiers dead on snow, in the blood. But I tell my grandchildren, you don't see that. I don't want it, you see.
My father worked very hard removing the gold from the dead bodies. His output was 3 times more than any of the workers. He knew if there was any chance of getting me out, it would be because of the gold.
The bodies. Papa is taking out the bodies, putting them in a truck. I yell, Papa. He saw me, he says, go back. Я завтра приду тебя возьму. He said, tomorrow he'll come. Next day, he came and he says, this is my little girl. She's got a cross, she's not a Jew.
And then put us on the trucks and brought us to Stuttgart and stopped by the Daimler Benz.
With the grace of God, the Nazi commandant led us out of the concentration camp. He put us in the back of a truck and shipped us to work at the Daimler Benz factory in Stuttgart, Germany.
They took us to the a camp by Mercedes-Benz. They weren't making Mercedes-Benz, they were making bombs.
My parents were very happy we were all back together, but the worst was yet to come. One day, while working in the fields with my mom picking vegetables, a soldier called out my mother.
And he told my mother, come. And he took her to the barn. And then I see her crying. And so I thought he's gonna kill her. So there was an axe, you know, in there. I took the axe and I slowly went to the barn. And he was already on top of her. So I took the axe and I hit him right like that. And the blood came out from him like that. And his head went on the side. So Mama got under him. Barely she could get out. And then she grabbed my arm and we were running 2 kilometers back where we stayed.
I prayed for months for God to help us and end the war. Then the American planes came.
So the Americans found out that they're not Mercedes-Benz. So what they did, they bombed us. And that bombs went on our camp.
When it's like coming, then straight coming. Then with like go over you.
The Allies kept bombing the city. It seemed like it was never going to end. I was sure we were all going to die. After a few days of horror, the Nazis finally surrendered. The German soldiers took off their uniforms and ran into the forest to hide from the Russians. We had to hide too. The Russians considered slave labor as traitors. They felt we should have died before helping the Germans.
If they would stay, they would be killed by the Russians because the Russians probably would tell them, why didn't you join the communists and run away?
I run outside and I see these dark, they look like Moroccans kind of, you know, soldiers in these tanks. And they started showing me chocolates, you know, and I ran to them and they started giving me chocolate.
Russians came, an American, to the Germany. Papa was against communists, he didn't want no Russians. So he said, we're gonna run away.
So we ran away and we kept running. Everywhere we went, we were surrounded by death and destruction. We walked and walked, not really knowing where we were going.
And I heard the nuns crying, like they lost, the war is ended, the Hitler lost.
After roaming around Stuttgart's countryside for a couple of weeks, we came across some American soldiers. My father asked them in 3 different languages if they knew where the Armenians were. One of the soldiers spoke some German and understood him.
He said, asking, where are the Armenians? Oh, Funker Kaserne. And this is how we end up in Funker Kaserne.
Funker Kaserne became home for 2,500 displaced Armenians. We lived in the camp for 5 years until one day the famous restaurateur George Martikian and his wife came to visit us at the camp.
George Martikian came. We sang for him, you know. He had tears in his eyes. Then his wife came. We gave her flowers and we sang for her. And she started crying and she says, I promise you, we'll do everything to bring you to America. So when they came to America, they did ANCHA organization. Then ANCHA brought 70% Armenians from Germany.
With the help of George Mardikian and the Lutheran Church, we were on our way to the promised land, America.
We were on General Macrae boat, which was soldiers' boat, not for people. Then we almost drowned. Something was wrong with the boat. God saved us, he didn't drown. Then we came to New York.
The USS General McRae ended up sinking in the New York Harbor just as we passed the Statue of Liberty.
want to make a movie about the camp. And we have a script already that one of the grandchildren wrote. And he sent it to me 5 years ago. And I read it 4 months ago, 5 months ago. And it's fantastic. And I think it should be a movie. And it explains all of it, how we got here. And I couldn't put it down. I really don't read scripts. Takes me 3 or 4 days, because usually they're boring. This thing was the story of his mother, the story of his family, and the story of Montebello, and the story of immigrants, and our story. We would like to get George Clooney to play George Mardikian. And I know, those are all, you're feeling bad because Mardikian looked more like me.
Thank you for watching. If you want to know the ending, click on the link, Inside Hell on Earth screenplay.